Hello and welcome to another Malta Network Resources video. Today I am in Guardamangia and this is related to the video that I streamed, the live video that I streamed last Saturday. And that was the stream about the late Prince Philip of the UK. And now today I'm here in Guardamangia and it's the next day, Sunday, and I'm going to find the place where he lived together with Queen Elizabeth in Malta. So let's have a look. Okay, so this is the main roundabout here in Guardamangia. Lots of birds in the trees chirping, and this is the old St. Luke's Hospital. And there's the police station. There's a BOV ATM, that's a bank ATM, so that's one of the ATMs which you can safely use without getting charged extra. So now let's basically find our way across the street. So this is still during the pandemic and restaurants and bars are still closed. Bars have been closed in fact since last October. Restaurants were closed I think about a month ago. I'm seeing that bar over there, the Romano, and it's closed of course. Like the other ones all over Malta and Gozo. You can't travel to Gozo right now, by the way. You can't cross over except for some work-related reasons, I believe, or some other essential reasons. Pharmacy here, which is closed today. On Sundays and public holidays there is a roster of pharmacies in fact. PBS, that's the television, the national broadcaster. Dolce Sicilia. Some good food, Italian sweets. Right now they're only doing takeaway also, or deliveries. Here we have the PBS house in Guardamangia.
So then Princess Elizabeth and her new husband was a naval officer. They lived at Villa Guardamangia for 2 years when they were first married. And they lived a relatively normal life before the sudden death of her father, King George VI, changed their lives forever.
We care for each other. That's nice. Hashtag we care for each other. How nice, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful positive message. Okay, so today I'm going to show you the outside basically of the residence of Prince Philip and Queen Elizabeth. And basically I'm going to walk there, okay? Basically I'm walking there, showing you a bit of Guardamangia.
Villa Guardamangia was loaned to the couple by Philip's beloved uncle, Lord Lewis Mountbatten, who rented it from the Shkembre family. Villa Guardamangia is in a dilapidated state and is going to be turned into a museum by the government which purchased it.
At the same time, you can see a few of the roads here, the streets, and the pavements. So, Prince Philip lived in Malta since 1949, and then together with Queen Elizabeth, who joined him, till a number of years. In the 1950s, basically, they lived together in this villa, named Villa Guardamangia. It was their home away from home. Malta was their home. And now, sadly, of course, one cannot enter this villa because it is being restored. So even though I'd like to show you inside, not allowed to go in. You can't just go in. It's being restored. Over there is a 3D reconstruction which we can view. Online. Of course, it's nothing like the real thing. The real thing, once it's restored, it will be something worth viewing. It will be something you will enjoy viewing. Hopefully, I can show it to you in those days. Once it's open again, you'll be able to view it. I think now you've seen a few streets of Guardamangia. And we can now turn to the right, if I'm not mistaken. And to the left. And where did I? No. This is it. So now we walk on. So, this is interesting. It's good that I walked through here. This is the Commonwealth War Graves. It's a military cemetery. During non-working hours, like today, it's closed. Okay. Right, so we can have a look. Okay. So let's go on. See the trees in the cemetery. At least those are still there. They have been left untouched so far. Let's have a look here. So from here we can see a lot of these war graves. Commonwealth War Graves. It's the Pietà Military Cemetery. One of the things is you're always seeing these cranes. Wherever you go, you see a crane. For sale. No junk mail, please. Right, so this is the Tella Ta Guardamangia, so basically it's Guardamangia Hill. There's an old building there, let's see what it is. Some very old columns. St. Augustine College. Committed to the principles of inclusion. Okay. With a bird on top. Hello, Mr. Bird. Where's the way to Villa Guardamangia? Do you know the way? No. And here, I'm seeing Queen's Flats. Queen's Flats, Queen's Flats. We're probably close now. And Victoria Flats also. So the nomenclature tells us that we're getting close. And I think that's the building. Yesterday apparently there was a ceremony and they've placed flowers here. So we have Casa Guardamangia. currently being restored. As I said, it's being restored. You can see what a beautiful building. Currently, you can only see the inside using a website. Using some 3D software. Okay, so while I show you this, in an inset you'll be seeing this a couple of minor screens. That's basically, you see it in a picture, you'll see a few seconds from this on that website. I don't know if that's part of the building over there. Alright. I think we can get a move on now. Building here too. Let's see what we have here. Now that we're here. This is still... Okay, this is still part of Villa Guarda Mangia. In fact, I don't think we can go up. As I said, there was a ceremony by the George Cross Association yesterday. It was in the news. And they left these flowers, these beautiful flowers. And also from the Rennes Association, I believe. So you can see these. And that's the main door of Villa Guarda Mangia. Okay. So it seems that everyone is coming to film it, take photos. Yeah, that's so here. That's a part of St. Luke's Hospital, which means that we've come around to where I started the video. This is Villa Messina. This video here for today. I invite you to check out these videos on the left or on the right, And I'll see you in the next video. Remember to like this video, to give it a boost. And thanks to you, other people will manage to see it in YouTube. Thank you very much, and bye from Malta Network Resources in Guardamangia, Malta.